Yeah, how are you feeling?
I am feeling excited, a little bit nervous as well, but the overwhelming feeling is excitement. Just want to get on there, man. Do you know what I mean? Step up, let my light shine, share my message. You know, I'm not pretending to be anything else but me.
Tell me, who you got coming tonight?
So we've got Vicki Anstey from SAS Who Dares Wins, Esmee Gummer from SAS Who Dares Wins, the Richmond Magazine here, Richmond Twickenham Times, Pam McMillan are here, all the guys from WeFix, all the guys from Oak, all my friends and family. So yeah, it's going to be good, man. Grateful for them all to be here.
I think you're late for your presentation.
Let's go and do this, come on, man. Roll around with nowhere to go. Argue with the homies over who's gonna roll. But my goody mob has some food for the soul. Till it's 2 in the morning when the rain hits the windshield. And everything is still. Nothing really is a big deal. One hand on the steering wheel. And we gon' be alright.
I work with a lot of writers. I've been involved in a lot of books. And it's rare that you come across something that has what I think gives a book true magic, which is the personal connection between the reader and the author. It's a one-to-one thing, and that only works if you have an author who is prepared to bare their soul completely and utterly, which Michael was.
Hi guys, my name's Esmee. If you did watch the SAS show, you probably didn't see me. I was the one that got quite close to the end and everyone went, was she even in it? But I'm really glad. So basically, yeah, that's where I met Mike and I'm really happy to be here. And I'm really honoured that he asked me to come and speak. I think the story that Mike really likes about me that I will share with you is about 10 years ago, I got paralysed from an operation that went wrong and I learned to walk again. And that's something that I think connected Mike and I together, was the sort of adversity side of it and the things that I'd faced and that he faced, and we could really connect. Every single one of us in this room has fought a battle of our own.
Thank you. Mike is proof that you can change your life. You can turn it around 360. And then you can have the bravery to share it to help other people. I still find it inconceivable that Mike, the Mike that I know, is the same Mike in the book. I can't figure how someone as gentle and humble and loving as he is could ever have been a violent, self-destructive, hardened criminal. And if Mike's taught me anything in the time that I've known him, it's the power of forgiveness, acceptance, and understanding. It's the belief that everyone can change, that we're not born inherently bad, and that we all deserve a second chance. I'm blinded by your grace, by your grace. I'm blinded by your grace. I'm blinded by your grace.
I feel emotional. Oh my gosh. It's so good hearing Vicki and Esmee. Means so much. I'm just grateful. I'm grateful you're all here. I sort of still have to pinch myself that, like, this is all of this, you know, like Pam McMillan and the book, and, you know, it's just, it wasn't written for me, this sort of life. Really, I shouldn't be here. I should, you know, be in prison or dead, and I'm not. And, you know, I'm grateful to be here. I think about life and I think about how we're all very busy chasing things, material success. And do we ever take a moment to stop and pause and really let the people know in our lives that we love them? I want to invite you all to do something here. Now, you might have brought someone you love with you tonight. If you have, I want you to turn to them and say what I'm going to say. If you haven't brought that person here, and there's someone in your life who you do love, I want you to take your phone out and I want you to send them a text message. I want you to tell them how much you appreciate them. The theme I want you to go into this with is, if you were to leave here and die, would that person know how much you love them? Just before we finish, I wanted to know if anyone here would like to meet some of the characters from the book, because there's some of them here, yeah? Okay, Okay, I'm going to introduce you to some of these characters. So the first person I introduce you to, whose name is different in the book, some might know him as Jake, the guy who taught me how to fight, taught me how to get high, taught me how to drink. I don't think Mary needs an introduction, does she? Mary, get up here now. Come here. Mum, would you please join me on stage? My brother Justin.
Not so little, bro.
Not so little anymore.
My beautiful wife.
Come up here. Without these guys here, none of this would be here. And without all your guys' support, it wouldn't be here. Change is possible. And yeah, everyone, let your light shine. Go and live your dreams. Love you all.
For years, we used to knock about when we were young kids, and he's a massive inspiration, huge part of my recovery.
I nearly cried. Whenever Michael tells me this story, I really get emotional because I know his story from inside out, and I want to cry basically.
It takes so much courage to actually share your story and be that vulnerable, like, to the world. And the fact that he's not left anything out, he's completely made himself vulnerable. And shared so many things that I bet people would never even think twice about telling their best mate. And I think that's the amazing, that's again, Michael being selfless, to share that story. It's amazing. People need to read it now.
The crazy individuals who did SAS and Jesuits met Michael in Santiago Airport in September last year. And over the course of the 5-6 days that he spent on the program, on the course, we just learned what an incredible human being he is. The story, the experiences that he's gone through, the trauma, the domestic violence, the drug addiction, etc., etc., and the way he's turned that around.
Had so much heart, and he made me feel like he knew how to make me feel. I'm not upset quite often. He was the one that I could go to speak to, and he just knew how to make it better. It's not even dry. He has the biggest heart. I couldn't have done it without him.
It's very good. Very inspirational, very positive. Dragged me back from the brink.
It's been super inspiring. And to be honest with you, when I was young, the way that I looked at Michael as a friend, as a person, I only ever saw him the way I see him tonight. So I'm just so happy that he's actually made it to that vision that I already had of him as a kid. And I'm just so proud of him. The stuff that he went through and be able to turn it all around, come out the other side and use his experiences to inspire and help other people, I think it's amazing.
Amazing, great to see everyone. Was a bit emotional as well, getting up on stage and, you know, a mixture of emotions. But what I wanted to do was just bring all of me, even the vulnerable part that was emotional and a bit tearful. And I think the best part for me was making that little bit of space for everyone to send some love out to the world. You know, like, we don't often get time to do that. So for me, that was a goal. I'm happy, excited. Manchester tomorrow. Mate, let's go and do it. Yeah, cool, man.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Hey,
dude. Where are we going today?
I-161.
Manchester.
Money on the map.
Hey. How long we got, Luke?
About
an hour?
Yeah, 60 miles.
About an hour.
How you feeling, Luke?
I'm feeling good, mate.
Carload of recovery.
Yeah, mate. All sober. Also, how many years of recovery we got in here? We got 11. Four and a half. So I got 11 and a half. Four and a half. So that's 17. Six. Is it?
16.
Sorry. Jeez, yeah. Maths was never good. You never saw my home business.
No, let's work this out. So you're 11.
11 and a half.
11 and a half. You're four and a half.
Four and a half.
That's 17. 16 and a half.
No. So you got half and half.
Hang on.
Right, 16.
Yeah.
How many alcoholics do to add 11 and a half, 4.5.
Is that your best moves?
That's all I got, mate.
The old school hip hop.
Vicky? That's all I've got. Actually, now just focus on the road.
That's all I've got.
I provide everything you need, and I like your smile. I don't want to see you cry. Got some questions that I gotta ask, and I hope you can come up with the answers, baby.
Let's do this. Let's do this. Hello there.
Can't really see you. That's better. That's better. You've got your better side. Is that your better side, or is that your better side?
I don't know.
I think that's your better side.
Maybe put a table in or something like that. And how would you still have love
for me? You do. opening my Instagram account. So, there you go. Suggested. All done.
Wicked. So the name I gave you, Polsky Luke.
Yeah, I like it.
What have you added to it?
69.
Dirty. Place. You know people take pictures of their food.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm taking pictures of our plates because it was just that
it
good.
It was delicious, actually.
Wasn't it? How are you feeling now?
Filled to the brim.
You're not recording this, are you?
I am. Yeah.
Please welcome to the stage, Manuel.
So, thank you, Michael. You're a legend. Love the book, mate. Love the book. I'm here to tell my story today. Michael's asked me to come. We've done a mountain climb, haven't we? So I really appreciate it. I'm really honoured to be here. Thank you. And thank you, everyone. I suppose the only man I ever had in my life as a child was my granddad. So my mum struggled. My granddad died. She struggled heavily from that. Again, drink, alcohol. That's all she ever knew. Just disowned me. You crave that love, don't you? When you're not getting it, and I craved it, and I craved it, and I just kept getting thrown back and thrown back and thrown back. So my idea of being an adult was different to probably other children's. You know, I had no role models. I just made it up. I had to make my life up as I was growing up.
Now, Mike, you know, you've been down that. Where are you, Mike? Where have you gone? You're with that. You just moved, sorry. So when you read Mike's book, by the way, I'm going to divert a little bit here. I was reading this book, and I was, you know, some stages in the book, I was actually, like, tears were coming down me, because it is really upsetting. You'd never expect him to have gone through what he'd been through. He's lucky to be alive. When you read that, I don't know if you've read it yet, but I read it, I loved it, like, brilliant book. He's lucky to be alive. So you've done the right thing, Mike. I'm really impressed, mate, by everything you've been through. How you've come out on the other side, mate, I don't know how you're actually alive. Mate,
what is self-belief? And I think about, okay, self is me, yeah? Self is the I, me. What is the belief? Okay, it's a set of beliefs that I believe will get me to a place in my life where I can achieve happiness. I believe that comes from two places, community and history. And so as a kid growing up on a council estate, I look around my community at what people are achieving in this community. And if you look at a scale of 1 to 10, I'd say a 0 would probably be the heroin addict. And like a number 10 would probably be the postman. You know, there was a guy who lived on my council estate. Lovely guy, really lovely family guy. He had two daughters and he had a job and he turned up to work every day. And so he was like my number 10. Do you know what I mean? And it was like, okay, so that's my scale. Where do I fall on this scale? Could I be a postman one day? Well, I think I could. So I sort of gave myself about a 7. But then I think about the history. And the history is, okay, well, what have the men in my family history done before me? And I looked at my dad, who was a drug addict in and out of prison. I looked at his dad the same. All my mum's side were the same. And my self-belief sort of dropped a bit. I went down to about a 5. I thought, yeah, maybe it's not achievable for me then. Maybe I'm almost destined to go down the same route that they went down. I got to about 12 and I went to places like Richmond and I saw how wealthy everyone was, and suddenly my scale of 0 being a heroin addict and 10 being the postman, I realized actually the postman was about a 5. No disrespect to any of postmans, but this is how I viewed it as a kid. I was like, okay, the postman's about a 5 and these guys are a 10. I'm never going to get to a 10. And in that moment at 12, my self-belief plummeted. But the belief I held the whole way along essentially was that happiness was a number 10. Wealth, success, a house, all stuff that was out of reach for me. And if happiness was there and it's so out of reach for me, then why should I bother with life? Because I know I'm never going to be able to achieve it.
It was really eye-opening to appreciate everyone around you and everything. I think sometimes it takes someone to tell a story like that, from rock bottom to where they are now, to sit and appreciate what you've got in life.
So you got your book?
I have read it last weekend. Come put it down.
I know about Michael, I'm on Instagram. You will know me as Judy 72.
Oh, I know you. I know you.
I'm traveling from Birmingham.
Okay, are we all in?
Sorry.
What got me about the book and reading it is how similar in certain ways of my childhood or parts of it, what I related to. And the parts of that book of how we grew up and learning the hard way, it just take a call for me in so many different ways. Like, I related to that, so many similar, even though we're a different kind of life, there were lots in that book what I could just demonstrate to you. And, you know, honesty, the honesty of it, which I loved, and, you know, I just loved that first part. You know what he's doing.
And I read his book, and I've read it already. You know, and you get to, you know, speak to Mike as we do now. He said that I would never believe he was that monster that I read about. I couldn't really believe it. You know, I thought it was. It's like, it'd make a good movie if you put it that way.
My distant cousin.
Got you posted it?
No, mate.
So what are you doing? You're gonna hate me by the end of these 3 days.
Oh my god, that is so terrible. It's like, what are you doing?
How was it tonight?
Oh man, epic. Epic, mate. Is this epic. What you're doing? So much love in Manchester. So much love. For everyone who come out, so grateful, man. Honestly, the love in Manchester's been unreal. So yeah, man, feeling blessed and feeling grateful.
You ready for the 6-hour drive tomorrow?
Yeah, ready for Aberdeen.
You ready for the 6-hour drive?
Not sure, mate. No. Aberdeen, we're coming for you, man. Hope you're ready for us.
Good morning.
Morning.
Where are we going today?
We're going to Aberdeen.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Putting in the postcode now.
All right. It's grey weather here. And what are we going to be doing in Aberdeen?
Louise McCullough. We're gonna go swimming in the Scottish Sea. In the Scottish Sea.
And it'll be alright for you because you're Polish, isn't it?
Oh man, just so much love last night. Met so many people I've been connecting with on social media, so yeah man, just feeling really grateful, full of love in my heart now, just bursting with love, so yeah, feeling good.
Is that Lake District? No, I'm not sure if that's, no, I think that's the Pennines. And the Lake District's to the left, isn't it?
Double
Yorkshire Dales.
Times, I ain't telling no lies, I just run it up. Never let a hard time humble us. Double up. I ain't telling no lies, I just.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Welcome to Scotland.
Four. Have you got a dirty even a wish you
was it? Right, best.
You need a wee?
Wee.
Michael, what are you up to, man?
I need a wee Jimmy Riddle.
That's it.
That's not a terrible Scottish
accent. That was, wasn't it? You're a bit of a tourist, aren't you?
I am, mate. Proper tourist. A little magnet for the fridge while I'm here.
Where are we, guys? We're in Scotland.
We're in Scotland.
Scotland. Okay, then.
Lord knows it's a cold game. Switched up on you hoes, man. Big body take both lanes. Backseat blowing propane.
If you look hard enough, yeah, you can see a haggis. See the grass go, just look, there goes. It's long now.
Part with the low fade. I was standing in front of Knicks with my sack for the whole day. Drive-bys, that was road rage. And we park and hop out, learn levels to this whole thing. Old school, play the OJs, trying to make a slow change. Mama still slaving for a low wage. Trying to double up, yeah. Three or four times, I ain't telling
we're
no.
We're in Aberdeen,
lie.
Mate. Here we are.
And what are we doing right now?
We're going to the sea, mate. And we're getting in and we're going to have a swim before tonight.
No lies, I just,
yeah.
I ain't telling no lies, I just
stop
4, 3, 2, that's time. I got to you that money. My dreams.
Amazing. Love it. My life.
How are you feeling post-killing?
Hold on, I left my balls in there.
You jumped in. You've just got in the seat, yeah.
I did.
Man who doesn't like the cold. Straight in, and how was it, man?
It was actually alright. Room service. Come to service your room.
Come on.
Sure.
Come to service your room. Yeah.
Right, this is for the ladies of Instagram.
Oh no.
Ladies
from the Instagram. Leave. Oh, it's sausage.
There's no need to drop the tone, mate. Oh, sorry. No need to drop the tone.
Thank you very much, firstly, to Michael for inviting me here. It's been an absolute pleasure to come and see him again. The guy, as you probably already know, is an absolute legend and a true inspiration. I managed to get on the show, as you guys know, and I managed to share my story. Now, fortunately, I didn't get as far as I wanted to. However, from my experiences, none of us make financial gains out of these things. I think all of us that have went on the show were striving just to do something for ourselves. And I said on the show that I wanted to give something back to me. But I'm the type of person that to give myself something back, I want to feel like I'm actually helping other people. And the influx of messages that I got from that show being aired and me speaking out bravely was just phenomenal. I had so many people that were like, thank you so much for being able to share with us your story, your journey. Because I think a lot of people think sexual assault victims or rape victims or victims of domestic abuse are perhaps weak in themselves. And when you see such strong men and women like ourselves, you know, going on a TV show platform such as SES Who Dares Wins, it sort of shocks people. You know, we're not victims. You know, we're not these weak people. We're people that have went through hell and have fought to build ourselves back up. So I knew that I had to take that platform. And from that, I've now started to speak out bravely.
The SES thing was an absolutely amazing experience. And I have to say, Michael had a large part to play in how supported everybody felt and how much of the whole team he became and how encouraging he was to everybody. Like, we're all here to support Michael in his book, and if you haven't had the opportunity to read it yet, you must read it, because this absolute legend bears no resemblance to the person who starts out in this book. He is just such a charismatic, caring gentleman that if to go back and to actually read the book is really quite heartbreaking, because that's not the Michael that I know in any way, shape or form, and it's very hard for me to even consider that that's possible for me, you know? And I just think for you to have turned your life around the way you have done is just unbelievable. Your journey is just so remarkable that you should be so proud of yourself.
Your message, your main message is, you know, change is possible. And it's only because of you, I believe that my, you know, the change is possible for me as well. And you know, I still look up to you, and you're my main inspiration that for my, you know, that me wanting to be better and wanting to, you know, do all the work so that I can be a better man.
Wow, gosh, thank you all for being here. I'm here to promote the book and I'm here to share a bit of my story, but I'm also trying to spread a bit of love as well. Success isn't like the car, the house and all that. Success for me is like spending time with my family. On like social media and Instagram, you hear me talk about the real gold. Like the real gold in my life is my kids and my wife. If I was to step out of the room and my wife and kids were there and you were to say, what's daddy like when he's not on Instagram or, you know, doing whatever, that's how I would judge my success. What sort of man am I when the cameras aren't watching? My story is a story of change. Change is possible. You know, I'm 11 and a half years sober. I do lots of stuff to help men. I run a men's retreat. I set up a free online program
for people to get sober from alcohol and addiction. I wrote the book to inspire people. And I do lots of prison talks, school talks. And my life is just about helping the world. You know, how can I use what I've been through to help others? So, yeah, I believe in you guys and I believe change is possible. And, you know, thank you for all coming and being here tonight with me. So, yeah, thank you.
Very interesting, and has done a fantastic job. So, he's an ambassador for all young men, or older men out there, indeed.
Really good. Obviously, from watching the show with you about all the three contestants, but follow Michael on Instagram, being quite aware of what he's been doing and stuff. So, it's really cool to.
It genuinely, it made me cry. I just. This person has just transformed into this beautiful butterfly from this person who was probably actually not a nice person to be around. I mean, but that doesn't mean that there wasn't good in there somewhere, but it was just for him to find that and to become this most beautiful person.
I would describe him as fearless, incredibly brave, someone who's willing to face up to himself and his wrongdoings, it's not quite the word, but where he's accountable for himself and his behaviour. And I've seen someone who actually risks losing everything that he loves. His children.
I really enjoyed it. Got another 2.5 hour drive back home again though, because I live in Livingston. So I'd love to stay even longer, but I mean the people, the energy in the room has just been fantastic. And I'm just rooting for him. I know that anything he touches will turn to gold because he's just pure of heart. So really, really proud and very honoured and blessed to say that he's a friend now for life.
Matt, are you
getting
this?
I am.
Very good.
Hey guys, hope you're all well. Just wanted to say thanks to everyone who come out tonight. Scotland, amazing. Aberdeen, love you guys. Thank you very much. Just having some dinner now and then going to crash out.
Wicked kebab.
Good morning.
Oh no, I'm just woken up.
Where are we going?
We're going to the beach, mate. Yeah. We're going to go for a little run with Louise McCullough. She's going to beast us and then going in for a swim.
So Aberdeen's kind of between two rivers. So this is River Don.
Yeah.
Like the north one. And that's like Bridge of Don just there. We're going to Aberdeen Beach, just down by Bridge of Don, out by the Royal Aberdeen Golf Course.
Fantastic.
Amazing. Can't wait.
I'm still waking up, mate, please.
How do you feel this morning, Michael?
I feel good, I feel tired.
This is you finished, isn't it?
This is us finished now. So literally, this is our little treat we were looking forward to. Meeting up with you, getting in the sea. And then after this, we're going to have some breakfast and then go home. Yeah, head back down and reminisce on all the memories we made. It's been a great trip. Video of this. Gorgeous. Just gone for a morning run with Louise McCulloch, Posky Luke, Matt Mashup. Oh, amazing.
Just about, we're going to go in the sea now, yeah?
Shall I?
Excellent, look at that. like compared to yesterday, Michael, how was the swim today?
It's gorgeous. Definitely coming back to Aberdeen. Beautiful. We were just saying how Aberdeen has just been incredible. It's like probably the smallest group, but just amazing people and lovely place. Went swimming, had some lovely food at Sand Dollars Caff. Anyone in Aberdeen, go to Sand Dollars Caff, mate. Great food. And met two lovely women in there as well, Lindsay De Boer and Doreen Baird. Give them both a signed copy of the book. And, you know, just the people here are lovely. It's just a beautiful place, man. I just feel so grateful that I'm sober, you know, grateful to my higher power, grateful to everyone who come out to see me. Yeah, man, just love you all. Got so much love for you all, man. It's just amazing. Just feel blown away by it all, really. And good to have you guys with me. Good to have Polsky Luke, my mate, here with me, and you, Matt, as well. You know, you guys have been amazing. There he is. There he is. Let's hit the road, back to London.
One day. What diet is mine?
It's called the fruit and nut diet.
Is that because you're fruity and nutty at the same time? Good old Polsky Luke here has driven all the way from Aberdeen to, what, near Liverpool, I think it is.
Yeah.
How many miles is that?
350, I think I've driven.
Okay, recording.
You're recording. We just passed Banbury, and I was trying to work out if that's David Cameron's constituency. And, Michael here wasn't aware that David Cameron made mad love to a pig's head. You didn't know that, did you?
By the way, this is Luke's first ever story, and
I'm privileged
to be on your story, Luke. Your first story. Woo-hoo!
We are at Kew Bridge.
Yeah.
Thank you, Luke.
Thank you, Mass. Yes.
Polsky Luke.
It's been a pleasure to spend time with you, mate.
Likewise, bro. Michael, thank you, my brother.
Thank you, mate. Excellent journey.
Yes.
Can't believe it's over. Just wanted to say thanks to everyone who came out on the book tour. Aberdeen, Manchester and London. Big love to you all. Thanks for all your support. And see you all soon. Bye. Lots of love.